Hello everyone, Simon here. We're playing Assassin's Creed Rogue. I bought this game on a Steam sale, so we're gonna play it and add it to our Assassin's Creed playthrough collection. I also bought Assassin's Creed Unity, but I don't know if you guys know, but that game doesn't run on any computer. So I guess I'm gonna wait until I buy a new computer in about 3 years' time before I play Assassin's Creed Unity. I don't know, maybe I'll buy a computer sooner than that. It doesn't run on my computer, that's for sure. And it doesn't run on most computers, neither. It's badly optimized, that game. Anyway, we're not going to talk about Unity, we're going to talk about Rogue. Let's go play this game. I've played the first 5 minutes or so of this game to check the frame rates and the controls and the sound and everything. Everything looks good. And in fact, it looks like a expansion pack for Assassin's Creed 4. Which I'm okay with, because I quite like Assassin's Creed 4, so there you go. I might have to change the settings again, because I deleted the old profile and started a new one. Hopefully everything is still the same settings. The music seemed a little loud.
Stay my blade from the flesh of the innocent. Hide in plain sight. Never compromise the Assassin Brotherhood. These are the tenets of the creed, the principles I used to live by. I was a young man then. The Seven Years' War was about to begin. I could not have imagined what the future had in store for me, nor the cost I would choose to bear. My name is Shay Patrick Cormac. This is my story.
Alright, we're an Irish dude, and we're going right back into tree parkour. Yes, welcome back to Assassin's Creed 4, the expansion called Assassin's Creed Rogue. Let me just double check this, make sure everything is correct. Sound, yeah, that's correct. Video, yeah, okay, that's correct. Alright. Let's go. We have to assassinate that guy. I don't think this is timed, so I think I'm gonna actually... No, I'll come back for this, Alright, let's just play through. And then we'll come back for the loot. There is a loot lying around here. We don't have to get it right now, though. Alright, let's assassinate this guy. We're gonna stab him in the head.
Like for firewood, at least.
Or not.
Admit it, I nearly had you.
Nearly counts for nothing, Shay. And besides, no. That was just luck.
I make my own luck, Liam.
Ah, you've been saying that for years, but you're precious little to show for it. Or have you been spending it all getting out of trouble?
Well, you know, trouble just follows me around.
Let's head back.
Alright, we're heading back.
Come on. Captain Deliver André and his crew must have run into some trouble. Who knew meeting with smugglers would lead to no good?
So the game, like, the controls feel pretty good.
I still don't understand why you can't tell me what we're doing here.
Because Chevalier decided not to tell you.
I thought we were friends, Liam.
We are. But this is business. It doesn't concern you, Shay.
It feels just like Assassin's Creed 4.
Am I going too fast for you?
I'm just keeping an eye on you, in case you fall down and hurt yourself.
No, let me just synchronize first. Since we're here. Yeah, it's just like Assassin's Creed 4. Like, you start on an island. You go through some tutorials. Let me just get this, since I'm here.
This is more like it.
North Atlantic, somewhere. We'll figure that out later on. And there's like a sword thing here as well. Whatever that means. A Viking sword.
Hurry. We best not keep Chevalier waiting.
I think we're in Canada? I think we're in Canada.
Despised the... Where the hell were you two?
We're out hunting. What happened here?
My men were attacked by some English sea dogs.
Why, Captain Joseph, couldn't you fight them all off by yourself like you're always saying?
It is Capitaine Louis-Joseph Gautier, Chevalier de la Vérendrye. And you are dreaming if you think any training could make you into a proper assassin. Do you even know what that means? It means being responsible for an ancient and proud tradition. It means obeying your mentor without question. How else will we ensure freedom for the human race?
Them's pretty words, Chevalier. But I don't feel too free at the moment.
Well then, feel educated! How dare you show me such disrespect?
You mad, bro? Why are you mad? Why are you so mad, bro? This is so stupid, just randomly stop fighting people.
I will teach you some manners.
Alright, well, combat tutorial. Because, you know, why not? Come on. There you go, block and punch. Block and punch. Can we get an uppercut? Why can't we get the... Alright.
Gentlemen, stop! We got a common enemy, and I reckon he's close.
The Royal Navy attack my vessel and force my men to flee. We are stranded, and what is worse, the smugglers we were supposed to meet have been taken prisoner.
Shay and I will free those smugglers. You treat your wounded.
Who does that? Who just starts punching their own allies for no reason?
Take these. You'll need them.
Like, he might actually have problems. Alright, well, we're gonna...
Tread with care, Shay. The Royal Navy be ready for us. Remember your training.
Remember my training, what?
To teach him a lesson?
They don't stand a chance.
Where are your mates now, you filthy rat?
I don't remember any training. The game just started. Nobody trained me yet.
Keep an eye out, lads. Their pals are still out there somewhere.
Thank you.
There he goes again.
All right, let me continue to be sneaky. I think we can sneak our way through the whole thing, and we also have a friend who's doing a lot of the work as well. Let's see if that guy faces the other way for me. Oh, that's right. There's a tree here I should have climbed. Oh well, too late. Stab those guys, and then there's this guy. What happened here? That's what happened. Alright. There's a map on my map. Oh, here we go.
Do and how.
And free these guys because I'm here. And then we have to kill these guys on the ship.
Hunting, lads.
The Morgan.
No match for you. Yeah.
Yeah. I did better the last time when I wasn't recording. I managed to sneak my way through until the last three guys. Oh well, it doesn't really matter. Chinko! Actually no. Well, that wasn't really a chinko. Doesn't really matter, rescue these guys. Oh noes! It's okay, we don't have to do anything here, it's just the cutscene. So the hard work you don't have to do.
I was saving those fellas for you.
Very thoughtful. Maybe you were not completely useless, Shay.
Speaking of useless, those blockheads won't be needing this vessel anymore.
This pile of mail. You want her, Shay? She is yours. Now bring me back to my ship.
You heard, Chevalier. This vessel is yours, Shay. Juan, take the wheel. Some of the men you rescued agreed to join us. We have a good crew.
All right.
I'm not so certain about their captain, but next to me, you are the most experienced sailor in the Brotherhood, Shay. Besides, we could use another vessel, even this pitiful one.
All right, so we're not going to take the wheel just yet. I'm going to spend a little bit of time to grab all the loot on this island because I can and because we're here. And because the island is quite small, so if we remember back in our Assassin's Creed 4 playthrough, I would leave most of the loot and grab them off screen because it's like it's not particularly interesting to watch me do this. I'll do this island at least, and then I'll think about whether I record the collectibles. Maybe the collectibles are more interesting this game. I remember back in the last game, the collectibles just weren't that interesting. Like you would kind of sail up to a sandbar and then get off and then open a box and then get back on your ship. Like it's not that interesting. So I didn't record it, right? So if this is more interesting, I will record it. But if it's not, then I won't. All right. So let me just come this way. I think, maybe the tree was correct. I'll get back on the tree. Maybe the tree is not correct. Wait a minute. Am I lost already? Oh, that's right. There was like a cave. Okay, it's back here. It's almost invisible when you go backwards through there. So we need to... And there's like a wolf as well. Maybe we should do some hunting. Probably use some wolf pelts. Alright, so what do we do here? Nope, that's the way forward. I want to come this way. Oh, there's a box. Just grab this. We are collecting pounds. So we're gonna be buying stuff from the English, I suppose. Where is... Oh, there is. Alright, come back. Come back, Shanty. I think the Shanties are slower in this game, too. Which is good, because they were really annoying to find. Which one was it? It was Assassin's Creed 3. Oh no, that wasn't the Shanties, that was the Almanac pages. That was terrible. So I think I've said it before, if you didn't see it when I said it, I talked about how it seems like every time Ubisoft makes an update to the game engine, they make a terrible game. So Assassin's Creed 3 was pretty bad in terms of the game, so they made a new game engine. So Assassin's Creed 1 was kind of bad, Assassin's Creed 2 was good, and then Brotherhood and Revelations was also quite good. And then Assassin's Creed 3 was bad, and then Assassin's Creed 4 was good, and now Rogue is good, and Unity is bad. And if you pay attention, you'll notice that the bad ones are always when they make some major update to the game engine. And that's always the ones that end up being bad games. And it just seems like that every time they make an improvement to the game engine, they don't actually dedicate enough resources to also make a good game on the engine. Whereas when they use an existing engine from a previous game and make a new game but with the same engine, then those games are actually quite good because I guess they like focus all their resources on just game design instead of also the technical aspects of making the engine. And it continues to be true. So I haven't played Syndicate. Apparently Syndicate is quite good. And I think Syndicate mostly uses the Unity engine, the Assassin's Creed Unity engine. So I think it's still true that, you know, whenever they make a major update to the game engine, they put out a bad game. because it's a new engine, and then it's just not. I don't know if it's if they don't like they don't know how to use the engine properly, or if it's just that they don't kind of dedicate enough resources to the game design team as well as the engine team. All right, so there's all the collectibles on this island. Let's go back to the ship. It's strange. I mean, it's noticeable to me. You'd think that Ubisoft would notice the pattern that, you know, every time they make an update to the game engine, they end up with a bad game. And if they notice that, you'd think that they would do something about it, like, you know, just dedicate more resources to the game.
A pile of garbage, yes.
Ah, with a lick of paint and a few new cannons, she'll look as fine as anything on the Seven Seas.
Shall we begin, Captain?
Indeed, mate.
Look, Connor.
She's a mess, but she's still afloat. And her name's the Morgan.
Morgan? That silly fairy queen who ruined Merlin, the wise? Oh, she's perfect for you.
Firing cannons, okay.
The Morgan was an old goddess. She's the queen of war and darkness. She harvested the souls of fallen warriors. Perfect indeed.
Hard to starboard!
I guess that's more fun, collecting that fragment. There. Instead of having to get off the ship, you just charge the ship into it.
Shin, they will sink her!
Let's put the Morrigan to the test, Captain Shay.
Ready for battle, men.
Alright, so we need to destroy.
Fire! Stop them, boy!
Oh, did I just ram into this one?
Get those clues up! Fire! On the men! Get off the wind!
Haha!
They're tearing her to pieces! Do something!
If I can sail back into position.
They seem to be on their own, sir! Fire!
Let's grab that boot. That's already sunk. Let me see if I can hit that one. Oh, that didn't really do much.
Incoming ship! They're giving
fire!
I seem to be lagging. Okay, the broadside lags a little bit. It fires like half a second after you press the mouse. So, really?
This vessel is battle ready after all. I will return to what is left of the Gerfo. It's a long way home. We have repairs to do.
Sing hearty, lads! Chevalier is pleased with us!
Alright, well, that's a pretty good start to the game. I suppose the thing to do would be to...
What course would you have me set, Shay?
Time to report back to the mentor. Wouldn't you agree?
Wise words, Captain. Wise words.
The thing to do would be to push forward with the main quest line to unlock all the tutorials before we do all the side objective things.
What did you do? It's some kind of dormant virus? Shit! Hang on, I'm getting you out of there. Sorry for the rough exit. Earpiece working, check. You were just in an animus. Animus, yes? You were using it to access a genetic memory file in Helix labeled Shay Cormac? You work for Abstergo Entertainment, remember? Any of this ringing a bell? Your session triggered something bad, and it's affecting the whole building. We need to find your boss. You haven't forgotten your boss, have you? Melanie LeMay, zipper, chipper, overachiever? Here, take your communicator, check it if you got lost. Now let's get out of here.
Alright, well, let's
follow me. Double time.
I guess we're following
this
her.
Chaos is absolutely your fault, in case you're wondering.
We're back in Abstergo. Are you happy? Alright, we're back in Abstergo. Let's follow her. There's an arrow. Alright, let's follow the arrow.